Joining us now to talk about this is Sally Kohn, CNN political commentator, Hillary Clinton supporter and columnist for The Daily Beast, and Betsy McCoy, a former lieutenant governor of New York, Donald Trump supporter, and senior fellow at the London Center for Policy Research. Welcome to both
of you.
Thank you. Thank you, Carol.
Okay. So, Betsy, do you think that Trump's strategy won over the women that he needed, those suburban, Republican, educated women?
I do. I think that creating this separate little event before the debate kept the issue of the treatment of women off center stage, because what the polls show, the Gallup poll, the Pew poll, is that women, like men, consider the top two issues to be our stagnant economy and the increasing threat of terrorism.
Well, the first 15 minutes of the debate, though, were on Donald Trump's
well,
bus
that, comments. That wasn't his doing, but let me just explain.
It was his doing, he said them.
No,
let me just explain, please, that he was answering a question. But Mrs. Clinton isn't running on jumpstarting the economy or addressing the threats of ISIS, because her party has failed on both those issues. So she has turned the debate to a debate over political correctness. That is the theme of her campaign, the speech police.
Political correctness?
Yes, let me just finish. She has said she's going to make sure that men talk respectfully to women, that whites are taught
Shouldn't
to show
they?
More humility in the presence of blacks, that chubby beauty queens won't be fat shamed, that illegal immigrants will feel welcome, and that people who disagree with her will be labeled bigots, racists, homophobes, xenophobes, and all those other deplorable names.
So just let me get it straight. So you're okay with Donald Trump, with all the stuff he said on the bus, because as he said last night, it's just locker room talk.
Let me point out.
He addressed that issue.
It is locker room banter.
But it's okay because it's not politically correct.
It wasn't okay, but he measured it against the really big issues we're facing, such as Christians being beheaded or drowned in steel cages, people unable to find work because our economy is growing at a meager 1.2%.
Okay, we got it. So, Sally, your thoughts.
I find myself a little speechless at the moment, Betsy, and that's not a common phenomenon. Look, Hillary Clinton has a plan for the economy and for creating, not only creating jobs, but creating jobs with good wages. She has a plan for defeating ISIS. Notably, and this stuns me, I don't know how we've gotten to this point as a country, Donald Trump repeatedly was asked very clear, very simple questions about his strategy for how he would replace Obamacare, how he would deal with ISIS, how he would address tax issues, and he did not answer the questions. He just, hang on, I let you talk.
Yep.
He just kind of vomited a word salad all over the place. Now, that being said, I'm sorry, Hillary Clinton. This is like saying that Donald Trump trying to blame Hillary Clinton for bringing up the birther issue. That is preposterous. It is untrue, and it is the definition of Orwellian. He brought it up. He brought it up again and again and again and again. The reason we're talking about the sexual assault of women and misogyny in general, as well as discrimination and prejudice and hate in this campaign, is because of Donald Trump. Because he keeps bringing it up, because he keeps doing and saying things
Let's go back to the core issue, because women don't like how Donald Trump talks about women.
How he treats them, treats.
No, they don't. That's why they're not on his side at the moment, especially those suburban, educated women that normally vote Republican and are not this time around. Here's why they're confused. So Donald Trump appears with these three Clinton accusers, right? Paula Jones is one of them, and we played a little soundbite from her. But back in 1998, he was not complimentary of Paula Jones. In fact, he called her ugly. Let's listen.
Let's talk about another 52-year-old Bill Clinton. What's he need to do?
Well, I don't know. It's so embarrassing, and you really have to say, where does it stop? I would have done something certainly different than what they did. I mean, that all started it. Paula Jones is a loser, but the fact is that she may be responsible for bringing down a president indirectly.
Okay, so he went on to say, and we'll put the full screen up, put the graphic up, Donald Trump went on to say, of Clinton's accusers, the whole group It's truly an unattractive cast of characters. Linda Tripp, Lucian Goldberg. I mean, this woman, I watch her on television just vomiting. She is so bad. The whole group, Paula Jones, Lewinsky, it's just really an unattractive group. And now he calls all of these women courageous.
Well, they are so courageous. Courageous because they have come out to confront Hillary Clinton's false claims that she is a defender of women.
But
as the WikiLeaks information showed on Friday, Hillary Clinton has two personas, the public persona and the private persona. Those are her own words, and she is a defender of women. Politically.
But Donald Trump's message to America, first of all, let me just start by clarifying, because it just doesn't seem to be clear to Betsy or to the media, that Bill Clinton is not running for president. Just let's get that clear for starters. And second, Donald Trump's message, his marketing pitch to the American people, seems to be, don't vote for the candidate whose husband hurts women. Instead, vote for me, Donald Trump, because I hurt women.
That's not it.
What the heck is happening here?
All of Mrs. Clinton's paid ads are political correctness ads, pointing fingers at people. She doesn't like the way they talk. Whereas
her ads are his own words. She is quoting his own words, and he says they're nasty because his words are nasty. I'm sorry, but when does this stop?
Aren't going to elect the next president to be the speech police. They want a president who will jumpstart the economy. Americans are earning less now than they did in 2007. It's not an issue of how people talk. We want a president who will get the job done. Let me point out, as I did at the beginning of this panel, that the number one and two issues for women, as well as for men, are the economy and terrorism. And Mrs. Clinton has a failed record. She represents the status quo, not change.
Okay, so Sally, then why is Donald Trump losing 15 points among women?
First of all, Donald Trump, it's not just Donald Trump's words. He bragged about forcing himself on women. He bragged about sexual assault. And by the way, if we want to talk about accusers, there are women who have stepped forward repeatedly. There are active lawsuits to back up those claims, not just words. Let's just stop trivializing it as words. We're talking about his actions, and his actions aren't just offensive, they're criminal.
Spoken on this bus were locker room banter. I don't find it attractive. I'm the mother of three daughters and two granddaughters. But the fact is, Donald Trump apologized
Would the father of your children talk that way in the locker room?
I think many men talk that way.
Not a single one I know.
I have no idea.
Really? But you don't know who you married?
Well, I haven't been married to him in many years. So the fact is, let me point out that this election should not be about the speech police and political correctness.
Then he should stop saying offensive things. Stop insulting Muslims and stop insulting women and stop insulting black people.
And Hillary Clinton should stop insulting all the Americans she calls deplorables and unredeemables.
So let's equate her one statement for which she apologized with the
hundreds. It's not one statement. Take a look at her paid ads. They're all an insult to Americans. She tells Americans that they're systemically racist.
Sally Kohn, Betsy McCoy, thanks so much.